I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky. The first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, where I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. Gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. So much pain and so much dark, this world we stumble through, all these questions I can't answer, so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace.
Took a nice little trip down memory trail today. I got up early this morning and I walked out back, went down in the woods, walked across areas where Dad and I had done a lot of work, went down in the fields, in the woods over on the back side, down the ditch, took a nice look at the ditch and saw a lot of the stumps that my dad and I had cut several times in the past. It was kind of a nice reminiscence.
Cut them down with a
saw.
With a saw?
Regular old
two-man saw?
Two-man saw. And the woods look pretty good. There's some nice trees back there, and not much has been done to it since Dad got killed.
They used to have pigs back there in a pen up there. They don't have anything back
no.
there?
No, there's nothing back there now. Just nice rice land. But those trees are just as nice and pretty as you want to see today.
Well, hi, partner.
Hello.
How you doing?
All right.
Well, you slipped up on me.
Uh-huh. You got a watchman.
How's your golf game, partner? Did it take quite a while to tell me about that?
If I'd had some shoes yesterday, I'd been all right.
Well, the next time you come over, make sure you bring them. That way you won't have an excuse.
When Daddy came to Arkansas, he got on a boat at Portsmouth and came down the Ohio River till he got to the Mississippi River on a steamboat. And that's the kind, you know, that blows the air out, you know.
Cold and, or something?
Huh? I don't know whether it's probably
steam.
Cold.
It's got a horn and everything.
Huh?
That's steam.
Yeah, they have a horn. And when he came down here, he came to get a job. He was 18 years old, and he was leaving home to get a job because Grandma and Grandpa had 10 kids and raised 10 kids. And when they got through school, they all left. So he was the one that was leaving. He came on a steamboat. He landed over at Eddywell, Arkansas, to work in the timber. And they had a lot of timber over there. And him and some more men that came from Ohio came with him. But my dad's sister had been down here before. She was older than Daddy. And she came down here and they bought the Russell place where Henry Russell lived. Later, he didn't live there then. John Getson's daddy bought that land and he sold it to Dad's sister. And they lived down there. And when Dad come down here, he come over here to this part of the country. My granddad owned a whole bunch of land right around here in this section, Jobill land, back of Jobill's land. And what Aunt Maddie had over there and what Uncle Charlie had was all Grandpa's. And anyhow, he came to be with his sister, see his sister, and he met Mom. And that's where those letters were going backwards and forth from Eddywell, Arkansas to O.K. And I don't think they went together too long until they got engaged and got married. Mom was 18 and Daddy was 25 when they got married. So Daddy worked a while over there in the timber before they got married. They got married in 1900.
Yeah, that's in one of the letters.
Huh?
He came to O'Kane Church and led singing.
Well, whenever the church was organized, Daddy was living here. He helped build this house. And it's about 100 years old. But it wouldn't have been standing here if I hadn't done a lot of work to it now and then to hold it up. It wouldn't have been this good, and it's not very good now. But it's about 100 years old because Bob was 5 years older than me. And I had a sister that was seven years older than me. And then my oldest little brother was older than that. They lost him when he was a baby. So that's they married in 1900, and I think their firstborn baby was 1901. And then they had my little sister. I've got her picture in there, the only little sister I had. And we had a family reunion. That's before I was born. And my granddad used to have that field up there with all apples and peaches, all kinds of fruit, and Daddy, I mean, Granddad shipped fruit off, you know, to sell. And all that whole lot back there, was, we had some back here too after I was born. We organized our church in 1911, and that's before I was born. And Daddy was a deacon when I was born in the church out there. And they had a church down here at Winchester Open, and they called it. Daddy went down there to church, and went out to Old Kane Church, and whenever it was organized, well, Mom and Daddy both went in that church out there. And he led singing all the time.
This was before they married. This was before they married, when he came down on his visits.
And that's when he led singing?
He led singing, and they gave him fruit for leading singing. They give him a...
Oh, that's in that deal.
It's in the, one of the letters I read.
I didn't know that.
That's
certificate.
That one, you don't want to look at it?
This is where he took a picture for the barber.
That's letters from
I'm not going
home. Where did you get them from?
I'll have to get my yard mowed, son.
If we can mow that before we leave, can't we?
This mom was, do you remember this? Is one Christmas that we all stayed here and made pallets, and Daryl and Denver was pulled out the couch and slept right there. And
well, no, a lot of times we had to put the kids in the floor.
And this was Don and DeLoss and Vaughn and
Daryl.
Denver and
Daryl
all playing checkers.
Yeah, I know how they used to play checkers.
And the smoke was so thick, couldn't you breathe?
Uh-oh. Whenever they left, and Denver lost his life due to that smoke.
It's like that old bed you got.
It's me with my old piano that I had. Mm-hmm.
This was one day they were all, that was the Lost, Vaughn and Denver, and they decided to see who could outrun the other one. And they run down to that bridge.
And he's got his mouth open. He's got that lost as much air. Here's something.
Yeah, well, you took off a running.
There's the chain.
I don't know. We wasn't really trying to beat anybody. We just trying to see if we could run that far and back.
That's hard to do.
Here's
now.
Well, Tommy look with at his afro.
He got him a set of beard and stuff, hadn't he? That's when the him and Daryl were hippies.
Dot and Joyce looked like kids.
They made a deal in labor to use that property one time. Old Daryl, he said, Elvis ain't got anything on this
door.
He had 3 or 4 parking tickets he was having paid or something.
Hello.
No, Daryl.
That's nice. Certificate of baptism thing.
So you had no.
That a truck.
As in my youth,
yeah, that's what I say. That's what.
Still video camera.
March 19th, 1949.
I think Thomas is about
to. You was the
baptized.
You was 9, wasn't you?
I was born in 39, that's 49.
Well, I think it's 9 years old.
She might not have been there.
I've got a big picture back
there. She might not have been there.
What do you say?
She might not have been there.
You might not have been there.
That's Daddy's family.
Is that mm-hmm. good walking shoes right
yeah.
there?
That's him.
I get
all my shoes. Man, you're right.
Thank you.
to climb on
mountain be our land.
And there will be there no never to roam, no never to roam.
I'm waiting but
compare, beyond compare. I'm gonna share the greatest love.